No, Liza, Liza, we have an understanding. Oh, no, no, separate bedrooms.
I think we should get rid of the celibacy clause. It's cruel and inhuman punishment.
Yeah, well, I think you should exercise a little self-restraint.
I suggest a full-body workout, one-on-one. Oh, come on, Adam, don't you feel it? This irresistible magnetic urge. It's human nature. Wanting what we can't have. Oh, we've put our mutual longing under glass. I'm on fire, Adam. Break the glass.
Who said anything about a mutual longing?
On the bed. The other day, that kiss spoke volumes.
Bed. I wasn't me. I was drinking.
Wasn't the liquor talking? It wasn't. It was weeks of pent-up emotion bubbling to the surface. It was fate. It was fate sealed with a kiss.
Let's take this upstairs.
I'll lead the way.
No, just forget it. This could be important. It could be Haley or Sky.
Chandler, I realize it's late, but I need to see Liza. Is she still up?
Up? Yes. She's up. Yes.
Hello. Linda, Adam and I were just, going to bed.
Uh-huh. Well, we need to talk.
Well, can't wait till morning.
No. You can't.
Miss Kiefer doesn't seem like the frivolous type to me. I'm sure if she has something to say, it must be important. I'll see you ladies later.
You're leaving?
I just remembered I have a conference call to Tokyo, and I left the numbers of the office. Don't wait up.
Adam! I can't believe this. You walk in here, I had him just where I wanted him. He was all hot and bothered, he's ready to go to bed. I was going to consummate my marriage and consolidate my fortune, and you walk in here and you blow it!
Well, then I guess you know how I feel. Having to cancel my plans because of some bogus emergency that you trumped up?
What? Oh, how could you accuse
Liza,
me?
Liza, please, save your phony outrage. And don't try to deny your feelings for Jake because I know they exist. Whatever mind games you're playing, count me out. You sign my paycheck, but the buck stops there. That's it. My private life is not a part of your jurisdiction, so butt out. Unless, of course, you want to find another lawyer to broker this scam you call a marriage.
You know something? Think about this. Think about how many souls there are. Millions of, upon millions of souls in the universe. And to find somebody that is just perfect for you, that you are complete with, that you're happy with, it's a total miracle.
Don't I know it?
I missed you.
I missed you too. But I'm here. I'm here. I told Rosa that we set a date. She was so down, I had to.
Oh, hey, su familia es mi familia.
And she says she's very excited and she'll help you with everything, with anything you need.
Good, because I get a headache just thinking about all the things
I have
to do.
Let's keep it simple. Well, you're gonna have me for a long, 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 long time.
Mm. Hey, I heard a really great song today.
Yeah?
Yeah. What do you think for the wedding?
Well, let's try it out. Listen, what do you think for the wedding, huh?
It's your choice, man.
Well, I want some input from my best man. It sounds good.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
So how's business?
It's a little slow tonight, man. Hey, why don't you guys take the rest of the night off? I'll close up. Yeah?
Yeah, sounds great.
Okay.
Good night.
Palmer, darling. Mind if I join you? Oh, how lucky for me to find you flying solo this evening. And what are you drinking, darling? Oh, it's cognac. That's lovely. And my, aren't we the busy worker bee tonight? Oh, I'm sorry, darling. Top secret stuff, huh?
Who let you out of your cage, Marion?
You silly boy. I'm just taking myself out for a night in the town to leave Adam and Liza some much-needed privacy.
How is the lucky couple?
They're still basking in the honeymoon afterglow.
Marion, tell me something. Does Adam deal with his business kind of hands-on, or has his life with Liza forced him to parcel out his workload?
Oh, Palmer, you sly fox. I know just what you're trying to do. You're trying to find out if Adam's invigorated love life has left his empire ripe for the raiding, aren't you?
Just asked an innocent question.
Darling, the last innocent words you uttered were gaga goo goo. And anyway, why should I tell tales on my son-in-law?
Well, you are very well aware of his abysmal record when it comes to marriage.
Well, we're not all lucky in love, you know.
The sun may be shining today, but it's always wise to put aside a little bit for that inevitable rainy day.
Mm-hmm. Well, Adam takes very good care of me, but I've got to admit, darling, that I'm always open to counter offers.
Well, let's say that I value your friendship in the six-figure range. All right. If you need me, you know where to call.
I certainly do, darling. Well, here's to safety in numbers. Jake.
Not to put you on the spot or anything, but did you make up that little business emergency to get out of our date?
Oh, please. Not even my style.
Good. So did you get your work done?
Let's just say I did what I had to do.
Okay.
Is this seat
taken?
Oh,
no. Please.
Thank you.
Yep. There you go. So, I guess the fickle finger of fate has singled us out to finish our date.
Well, you know, my Aunt Grace would always say that fate was coincidence in a fancy dress.
Well, I like to think that everything happens for a reason, but I guess there is something to say for chance encounters. You know, lawyer jokes were real big when I was in college.
I know them all.
What do you call 10,000 lawyers at the bottom of the ocean?
A start. Why'd the shark spit out the lawyer?
Professional courtesy. What do you call a beautiful, sexy, attractive, articulate, warm-hearted lawyer?
Freak of nature?
A simple twist of fate.
You don't have to tiptoe, Mother. Everybody in the house is awake.
Oh, damn. I was hoping to catch you and Adam in the act.
Mother, it's nothing sacred.
Darling, I've told you that an eyewitness will help you in your divorce proceeding.
Mother, you could swear in a stack of Bibles nothing happened.
You mean Adam failed to perform his husbandly duty?
We didn't even make it past the prologue.
Oh, no, Liza, must I do everything myself?
Mother, I was doing fine. I had him just where I wanted him.
Supine and begging?
We were going upstairs. Belinda Kiefer showed up.
Well, why didn't you get rid of her? I mean, lawyers are a dime a dozen, darling. They breed like guppies.
I can't. She already knows my marriage is a loveless farce.
Oh. Well, what happened after she left?
Went upstairs to bed.
And awakened Adam with a sensuous kiss, I hope.
He had left, actually. I fell asleep. I don't even know if he came home.
Well, he's got to come home sometime, darling, if only to change his clothes.
Yes, he does. And when he does, I'm going to be waiting for him.
Mm-hmm.
glad you called.
Coffee?
Please. I was up half the night trying to brainstorm your way out of your marriage while cutting your costs.
Well, I hope you hit pay dirt.
Why?
I almost slept with my wife last night.
The operative word being almost.
Nothing was consummated. I left before she woke up this morning.
Well, are you telling me that you no longer trust yourself alone with Liza?
You go a couple of rounds with her in a darkened room. In case you haven't guessed, my wife can out-seduce a black widow if she sets her mind to it.
Must be genetic. Careful you don't end up a midnight snack.
Is that the sum total of your overpriced advice?
Your plot to catch Liza in flagrante with Jake Martin isn't working. You need a contingency plan.
Like what? I'm not going to give half my holdings to that gold digger.
We'll make Liza an offer she can't refuse.
How much is it going to cost me?
Plenty. But it'll work out better in the long run. Give part of what she wants and divorce her now, before you're in too deep and stand to lose everything.
What kind of proposition?
Right to it. That's my Liza.
My Liza? Are you connoting affection or proprietorship?
Affection.
That's nice.
And so are you.
Nice? Not a word applied to me. Neither patience.
Well, I appreciate directness. But will you indulge me?
I live for it.
You have any idea how attractive you are when your eyes sparkle?
3 compliments in less than 2 minutes. I think I might like this.
Good. I've been thinking about our relationship. You know, before we were married, I thought you were a bright, talented woman.
And now?
Now, I know that you're a brilliant, extraordinarily gifted woman.
So far, so good.
And I've also noticed that you happen to be beautiful and exciting.
Thank you.
You've even helped me with Chandler Enterprises.
Oh, I was just lucky to be familiar with some of your associates, Adam.
I would bet that luck has nothing to do with your standard operating procedure, Liza. You amaze me.
Adam, are you setting me up for something?
My hands are still a little cold.
Okay, well, this is a job for Mateo Man.
Mateo Man?
Yes.
Could I really be blessed with Mateo Man?
Yes, you could. Just wait and see. Here we go. One button. 2 buttons. 3 buttons. And the most important button right here.
Liza, I'm hurt. You think I'm buttering you up? Do you think I'm incapable of honesty?
Oh, I think you're perfectly capable, Adam. It's just with that much flattery, I'm looking for the hook.
Well, we're not in contract negotiations. Why would I want to hook you?
I have no idea. But if you want to talk about some sort of hook, you can ask, and you just might receive. No, it's me. Do you mind?
No.
Oh, okay.
Not at all.
Thanks. Hello? What?
I have a special little surprise for the lady that I'm dining with tonight. Would you serve this up with dessert?
Well,
You're going to pop the question tonight.
Another one you think.
Excuse me?
We're already married. My wife is blonde, beautiful, and lights up the room. You can't miss her.
Okay.
Dinner was absolutely delicious.
Yeah, been so much more tasty without Jake underfoot.
Oh, I don't know. Jake's not that bad.
Yes, he is. He's got a real talent for interrupting us at the most inauspicious moment. What? You disagree?
No.
Oh, good. Guess you'd be wrong. Anyway, I don't want to talk about Jake. I want to talk about you and me. How would you feel about going somewhere far, far away where the only thing there was to do was eat or sleep or fool around? You think you could get some time off from the hospital?
I think I could get a day or two.
No, I'm not thinking about a day or a weekend here.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking about something a little more extended. Like you and me for at least a week on a Caribbean island with nothing but white sand beaches and palm trees and clear skies and blue water.
The sun baking us and the night breezes cooling us off.
In my fantasy, there's not too much cooling off going on.
Oh, it sounds like heaven.
Yeah. Anywhere I am with you is heaven. Right now, I'm feeling the need for a lifelong fix.
Of heaven?
Of you. So what do you say? You up for a romp in paradise?
Yes.
Good. Then I'll just have to tell the boss lady I'm going to need a personal week for...
Oh, I'm so happy you're here. The cutting edge has a major problem. All I'm saying is that if you don't call Diane, she's not going
to
show up.
Why do I have to be the one that's call? I'm in the middle of a very important dinner here.
Aren't we all? If you don't call her, she's not going to show up. She wants to talk to the host. You're the host. We have to have her do the show.
Hey,
we promote the show.
I understand, okay? I'll call her. All I have to say about it is that, you know, you owe me.
May I?
Of course.
Yeah. You look lovely.
Thank you.
You enjoying your evening?
I was until business reared its ugly head.
Oh, man, the common complaint among those of us hooked up to TV types.
Mm-hmm. Yes, well, marriage to you meant business interruptions morning, noon, and night.
Ah, I resemble that remark.
Gloria. Hi, nice to see you. Adam? Hi.
Yes, have fun.
Great.
You too.
Don't
try.
Okay, great, thanks. Okay, bye.
All the gin joints of all the world.
Look, why don't we just go home?
No, we haven't had dessert.
Dessert? I don't need dessert, Adam. Really?
No, come on. Well, sit. Since last night, I've been thinking.
So have I. Let's go home.
I've been thinking that I haven't been entirely fair with you. You're a beautiful, exciting, extraordinarily attractive woman. And it's and yet you're trapped in a marriage that wasn't meant to be.
I don't feel trapped. Do you?
What I mean is, last night you made it clear that you have certain needs. And it's not fair that you should be caught in a situation where those needs cannot be met.
But that can be solved.
Yes, it can. I'd like to offer you your freedom.
That's your proposal? A divorce? Bye-bye.